We'll be taking a closer look at one of the most controversial health mysteries in recent years.
Originally known as Havana Syndrome, officials say the condition has now spread beyond Cuba to every continent.
Named after the city where U.S. diplomats and intelligence officials first suffered from dizziness, cognitive difficulties, even memory loss.
A cluster of unexplained concussion-like symptoms first reported among American officials and covert personnel in Cuba back in 2016.
He remembers the first time.
And that night, all the dogs started kicking off in the neighborhood, barking, which is very unusual for them all to go in chorus. And then this just loud sound just absolutely filled my room. It felt like my head was slowly starting to get crushed.
We agreed not to use his name. He is not allowed to say what federal agency he worked for.
And then the severe ear pain started. So I liken it to if you put a Q-tip too far and you bounce off your eardrum. Well, imagine taking a sharp pencil and just kind of poke in that. It was very jarring and painful. And eventually I started blacking out.
With the first public reports coming from Cuba, the affliction became known as Havana Syndrome.
That mysterious thing where these diplomats and spies working in Cuba started saying some weird stuff, like that they were hearing bizarre sounds, they were feeling bizarre sensations, they had hearing, vision loss, memory, balance problems, they were nauseous, they were getting headaches. Well, today, we are now learning that one thing has been ruled out about what happened, at least according to a newly declassified review by U.S. intelligence agencies. They say this so-called Havana syndrome was probably not originating from a foreign adversary.
If not a foreign adversary with a weapon, what then explains the symptoms that these people have come forward with? 1,500 reports.
Across 96 countries,
yeah.
It's a great question for which the intelligence community does not have a great answer.
All right, so you've got kids and a teacher, and they all start this uncontrollable twitching. So bad, CDC comes in to investigate, and they find...
Well, they found that there wasn't an explainable cause for the illness, and there wasn't anything in the environment that was causing the illness. And actually, it's a documented phenomenon called a mass psychogenic illness. So this is something that's actually been reported as far as 600 years ago.
It's in their head, is what you're saying.
Yeah, it's in their head, but some of the symptoms are factual. Feeling dizzy, feeling headaches. It's a reaction to something in their environment, and you know, sometimes it's prescribed to anxiety or stress, probably as the most common cause.
And I was reading about this, and they said that it was in this case, every single person, female, including the teacher, that
yes,
this is something that happens to women more than men, where there's no reason for it, but all of a sudden, they almost have these, you know, convulsions, these seizures.
Tina Anifer, a former Foreign Services officer stationed in Havana, who told NBC News about the moment this all hit her, saying, in her words, I felt like I was being struck with something, pain that I've never felt before in my life, as if I'd been seized by some invisible hand and I couldn't move.
Sanjay spoke to the CIA's first investigator into the situation, Dr. Paul Andrews, who himself became a victim when he traveled to Havana to investigate. This is a preview.
I think I went to bed probably around 11:30. I slept in my jeans and a t-shirt in case I had to evacuate quickly. And about 4:56, 4:57, I was awakened with severe pain in my right ear. I had a lot of nausea and a terrible headache, and I never suffered from headaches before. The amount of ringing in my ears was just astounding, and things were getting worse and worse and worse. And I started to hear the noise, and I'm really in disbelief.
And you believe that that night there was some sort of injury or damage to either your inner ear, the nerves around your inner ear, or your brain?
Correct. Absolutely.
Then, in his hotel room, the trip took a dangerous turn.
I woke up in the middle of the night because I had this incredible case of vertigo. It felt almost as if I was in some kind of, you know, carnival ride. And I'll tell you, Catherine, I'd spent years in war zones of Iraq and Afghanistan. I'd put my life on the line. This was the most terrifying experience of my life. I had no control.
I mean, just to hear someone actually describe these unexplained health incidents, what transpires, somebody who never had these symptoms before suddenly comes on. No advance warning and no indication. I mean, concussion-like symptoms without a blow to the head. That's why they call this, that's why we're calling it the immaculate concussion. You know, it's hard to explain, but you hear from somebody who's a physician himself, goes to investigate, and develops that.
Her flight from Singapore to Vietnam was delayed for several hours because at least one U.S. diplomat had to be medevaced from Hanoi over the
weekend. But some have questioned whether the syndrome is real, suggesting that the stress caused what's called a psychogenic illness of the mind, which is now spreading.
And this was one of the biggest investigations in the modern history of the intelligence community. They conducted for years intensive look at as many of these things as they could get their arms around. And they found not only no evidence of foreign involvement, they found evidence refuting foreign involvement. Remember, the working hypothesis for a while was this was an energy weapon, potentially
That's right.
microwave energy. Russia was the likely suspect. But they worked really hard to confirm that hypothesis, and they ended up refuting it. And they're saying there is no one set of symptoms here. So they're really saying there isn't a Havana syndrome per se. There are a lot of disparate and different situations.
So this is just like one of these things that's like the Bermuda Triangle, destined to forever be kind of a mystery?
In the last year, new evidence has emerged. That led a panel of scientists sponsored by the State Department to conclude that pulsed microwaves were most likely responsible in at least some of the cases.
For many of these people, real injury, real neurologic injury took place. It took place through a mechanism that we cannot precisely pinpoint, but we think could be linked to this relatively unusual mechanism that really has not received a whole lot of study, pulsed microwave energy.
Definitive evidence of what started in Cuba remains elusive. Some link it to electronic surveillance, others a weapon. But with cases now emerging in every continent.
Since 2016, there have been 200 cases of the Havana syndrome. 200 cases. It has been reported in Australia, Colombia, Russia, Georgia, Kyrgyzstan, Poland, Serbia, Taiwan, China, Uzbekistan, even here in India.
So who or what is behind these directed energy events? Is it an intelligence service? Is it a nation? Or is it some other entity?
The closest the U.S. has come to an answer is microwave radiation. And even then, there is no evidence to back it. It almost sounds like a sci-fi movie where villains harness the power of sound to attack unsuspecting diplomats.
But that doesn't explain that core group of people, particularly at the U.S. Embassy in Cuba,
right,
where some of them have documented brain injuries, and they can't really explain it. They've said environmental factors, pre-existing medical conditions. They even talked about, in some cases, HVAC malfunctioning can cause pressure in a room, which can lead people to think, but that doesn't cause a brain injury.
Is this an ailment, really, or a case of cloak and dagger espionage? We say good luck. We also say reality is sometimes stranger than fiction.
You know, we talk about how significant the power of suggestion is, how mm-hmm. powerful that is. And here in our newsroom, and I'm sharing a secret now, everybody, in our newsroom, we had some bed bugs last week. The exterminator was brought in. It's fine, no problems. But the moment we found out about it, mm-hmm. even after the exterminator, all the women in the area where I work, we started turning around and going, you feel itchy?
Right.
Psychologically, you just start thinking that you feel these things. There's nothing there. What? Are we all crazy?
No, but the subconscious is a very powerful force. You know, our mind is an organ, and it has an incredible power on what we do.
But it overpowers reality? It makes you think that something's happened even if it's not?
Well, it's sometimes hard to understand what the reality is.